Okay, then hello there, my name is Bodax and today I am back with another Soul Reactor Alicization Rising Steel video. And today was the first live stream we got about the first year anniversary. They announced some stuff. It wasn't the best live stream, but it was okay. And we got some nice news, you know, about some units and story and new mechanics and, you know, it was a nice live stream. So the anniversary, if we check out the Japanese website, and of course it's translated to English, the anniversary is scheduled for Sunday the 22nd of November. So that's the end of November. So that's when we can expect the anniversary units to arrive and the whole anniversary event to start, I think. I don't really know if this is the exact date or if they will begin before this, or because, you know, Google Translate is not the best, but this is what we understand from it, because I don't think they actually like mentioned that 22nd of November is gonna be the anniversary. So yeah, I just wanted to mention this, that 22nd of November may be the anniversary. So the first thing they talked about is the Moon Cradle arc that is gonna come to the game, which is not animated actually yet. You know, there's no anime about the Moon Cradle arc. And of course the Moon Cradle is right after... this is how Kirito and Asuna spend those 200 years, or I don't know how much they stayed in. And yeah, we're gonna get some story events, as you can see here. This is King and Queen, of course Kirito and Asuna, and then Iska and Shaita is also gonna be there. So of course it's not gonna be in Japanese, but the screenshots are from the live stream and they've been translated. So this is gonna come, and of course then they showed off some artwork of the Moon Cradle arc, and there's this these two new Integrity Knights that actually woke up. Those guys woke up, and then we have this other one with an eye patch, Edis, which is interesting because we actually got a new Edis leak kind of thing. I don't know where we got those images from. Let me show you. So here's that Edis that I'm talking about right now. I'm actually gonna not gonna talk about her that much because we don't know anything about her. She may be Fire Elemental because in her art, not in this one, in her normal art she has like some fire particles around her, and but this art is like, you know, it looks pretty damn nice. So right after that, they of course this guy's called Antokia, and you know, this is his voice actor, and then this guy is called Nergius, and then this is his voice actor. So then we got leader skills and member skills, which is interesting because Dokkan has leader skills. Dokkan really focuses on leader skills and how you run your teams, and you know, it's a bit restricted, if I can say it like that, because you can't like use villains and heroes together, if I can say it like that. So I hope this won't really restrict our playstyle by that much. Like, I really do hope that it's only like, okay, this guy's Dark Elemental, maybe this Kirito, and he will give Dark Elementals I don't know how much more percent attack. Like, I hope it's not only to good characters that are not like villains or those kind of stuff. But we can see that this is a party skill, I guess. This is a member skill. You can see it under the P and S. And then this is the leader skill. So we already know that this Kirito has a leader skill and a member skill. But I don't really know, because they wrote that certain characters will get leader skills or member skills. So, and this guy has both. Now, please don't mess this up and just do this right. I think the anniversary units should be the best, should have the best leader skills and member skills. because they are the anniversary units and they should be the top 1 characters, by the way. I hope they make them top 1 characters. That was kind of all for that. Then we got some of these new stamps or emotes that you can use in the guild chat. Now this emote was a bit weird, because we all know where they took this from. So yeah, I'm just gonna hop over that. So then we got active links, which is basically combos, I think. So with the right timing, first things first, let me say that this is only for show. These are not like element changes or anything, I hope. This is only for show, because you can see this is the Dual Blade Kirito, the Dark Mantle, and this is the first Edis that we got, Dark Mantle as well. You can see their maximum broken arts here. So, active link skills certain characters can use this, of course, together, like you see when the next character that attacks, and of course you can get some bonuses, more damage, I don't know, more charge maybe, they could be get creative and give units more charge or more break. So for now it's more damage is all they are talking about, and we have a video right here, I hope it's not that loud. So as you can see here, he just attacked, like this is not an incarnate skill or anything. And then right after, Edis attacks as well. And then, here it is. And this won't work with any character. Like, this is only with maybe Kirito and Asuna, like they have to be close. So this is a very, very interesting mechanic in my opinion, and you know, ranking events will get even crazier. And these are the bonuses, I'm not gonna like read up all of them, you can check it out in their website. They actually made a new website for the first year anniversary, and you can find that in their Twitter. So you can stop the video and read over the bonuses. And then we got this crazy, crazy banner, up to 110 units in a scout, I think, in one multi, every day. Now, during the event you could get up to 110 free scouts daily, if Kirito appears at the end of your scout. So, you know, if Kirito is in the last spot. I don't know if this is any Kirito, but this, I think you will get this animation, and then, you know, there will be just more units in the scout, I think. So this is the banner, this is how it will look like. I have no idea if we will get this daily. Do we get this daily? Oh yeah, daily, okay, so we will have this for a week. So we will have 7 chances to get this, and then there is a 3-star or higher guaranteed on the 11th spot, which is also a very great chance. But you know, as you can see here, every kind of character will be in there, so you will have a hard time of pulling a Kirito, but if you will, you will get multiple 4-stars easily in that multi-summon, of course. So this will be very, very, very crazy. I'm very hyped about this. And then we got some info about the anniversary login bonus. I mean, we do have a pre-anniversary login bonus right now. And then in the anniversary login bonus, we'll get 15 gold scout tickets and exchange swords and many, many other stuff. And in the middle of the live stream, they actually announced a random Yuki, you know, a Halloween unit, which will be a banner. I don't know if you wanna summon on this, because, you know, anniversary is right up, right in the corner. And then we got that crazy Edis as well, upcoming. So I don't think you really wanna summon on this Yuki. You can always get her. So, yeah, that's just my opinion, and I think she would be a Dark Elemental again because of, course, Halloween, but you know, that's just what I think. So yeah, that was it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed it and that I didn't miss anything. I really do hope I didn't miss anything. And yeah, sorry for the late upload. I was in school. I couldn't do anything about it. But yeah, I will see you next time. Bye.